Hi friends, welcome to Marco Insights. In this video, we're going to learn about anchoring bias in neuromarketing. Marketers, entrepreneurs, and business owners assume that most people make decisions by conducting research and then weighing the options. But that's not how most people make decisions. Instead, people tend to unconsciously latch onto the first fact they hear and base their decision-making on that fact, whether it's accurate or not. This phenomenon is called anchoring. Anchoring is one of the most fundamental principles of marketing psychology. Let's look at the definition. Anchoring bias is a bias that relies on the first piece of information received when making decisions, called the anchor. Once an anchor is set, new information is based around that anchor. In 1974, psychologist Amos Tversky and Daniel Kahneman published a research article titled Judgment Under Uncertainty, Heuristics and Biases. This article documented the first clinical evidence of anchoring effect. In the article, they described an anchoring bias experiment that challenged two groups of high school students to complete a lengthy multiplication problem. One group was asked to multiply numbers 1 through 8 and other was given the reverse sequence. Neither group was given sufficient time to solve the problem and arrive at a confident answer, only 5 seconds, and the tight timeline forced them to estimate. Tversky and Kahneman concluded that the final estimates were influenced by the numbers with which the two sequences began. The anchoring effect led the students whose problem started with lower numbers to estimate lower and vice versa. Both groups were wildly off in their answers. The solution to both the problems is 40,320. The key takeaway here is that each group was unduly affected by the first numbers they saw. Anchoring can either be unconscious or conscious. In the first case, the effect at work is called priming. In other words, people absorb information from their environment and then unconsciously use this as a point of reference when making decisions. This was demonstrated using an experiment. The participants in the experiments were told to spin a wheel of fortune and then were asked to estimate what percentage of UN countries were there in Africa. The results were rather interesting. The higher the number somebody span, the higher their estimate for the number of countries. Now, anchoring can also be conscious, in which case the mechanism at work is called adjustment heuristic. If you ask somebody what would they pay for a caffeine-based drink containing immunity-boosting ingredients, they will base their answer on the price of an ordinary coffee, because they have no other way of estimating the price of an unknown product. Let's look at how marketers use anchoring bias to influence buyer decisions. Number one is initial price setting. By listing an original price on an advertisement, customers are automatically anchored to that primary value. When this sits next to the discounted price, the chances of conversion rises exponentially. Number two is monthly versus annual plans. This is a classic tactic used by software firms. Offer a small discount for the annual subscription option and display equivalent monthly price next to the monthly price customers would pay to renew each month. Given these two options, many people will choose annual subscriptions to save money. Number three is manipulating price perception. Ever wondered why car dealerships put their most expensive models at the front of the display room when they are typically the slowest selling models? Or why a jewelry store keeps a $20,000 Rolex in the jewelry store window? This is because a $300 watch will always look like a great deal by comparison. Consider the case of Serendipity 3's menu anchors. In 2010, the popular New York eatery introduced a $69 hot dog. The pricey food chain made headlines and even landed itself in the Guinness Book of World Records for the most expensive hot dog in the history. The true purpose of this was different. Customers who were drawn by hot dog's publicity gladly ordered the menu's $17.95 cheeseburger. Even if it was too pricey, Serendipity 3's customers deemed it reasonable in comparison to hot dog. Next is multiple unit pricing. With the rise in wholesale shopping outlet, this tactic has held the spotlight in recent years. We all know that it's questionable to buy one bag of peanuts for $2 when you can buy 50 bags for $20. Next is increase prices gradually. When Apple launched iPhone X for $999, many people questioned who would pay that much for a phone. But it was Apple's top-selling model each week in the second quarter of 2018. Between the release of X and the subsequent releases of XS, XS Max and XR, Apple gave its customer enough time to adjust their expectations around iPhone's cost. The newer phones were anchored around the iPhone X price point. Since people had gotten used to the idea of paying $999 for an iPhone, $749 for an XR seemed like a bargain. Next is lead with core selling point. Does $5 for a cup of coffee sound completely ridiculous to you? Perhaps, yet thousands of people pay this amount at Starbucks without batting an eyelid. Starbucks has achieved this feat by selling more than just coffee. It has invented a whole lifestyle and a way of drinking coffee. Nowhere else will you find a spiced pumpkin latte or a blonde roast macchiato, and it even comes in a personally labeled cup. The Starbucks coffee houses have other USPs too, notably the setting, with comfortable sofas and armchairs that set them apart from other cafes. If you can convince your customers that your product is innovative in your core selling point, everything on your spec sheet will appear innovative. Next is gear acquisition syndrome. Gear acquisition syndrome is a constant desire to add new equipment to your collection. It tells photographers that their $5,000 camera is no longer good enough, musicians that their 400 kilowatt amp is no longer loud enough, and drivers that their last year's M5 isn't impressive enough anymore. Here, the previous specs are acting as an anchor for the customers, and any significant improvement suggests that there is a better product out there, and the anchoring bias leads the customers to buy them. The anchoring heuristic is a powerful psychological mechanism that companies can use in their marketing and sales campaigns. It works subconsciously and is effective even when people are aware of its existence. Used consistently and skillfully, this cognitive bias can form the basis for effective online marketing strategies that boost sales and revenues. But remember, the anchoring effect alone is no miracle solution. If a product is deficient in some way, no clever anchors will persuade the customers to buy it. So this was all about anchoring bias in neuromarketing. Hope you enjoyed the video. For more such interesting concepts, please check out our marketing concept playlist. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so that you do not miss out on any update from this channel. See you in the next video. Bye!